takes no more than a 2-year-old to figure out that the harder you hit something or the more energy you transfer onto that something, the faster it'll move. But what if I told you that this seemingly simple observation could help us understand the speed of light? Let's delve into it.
In his 1905 paper of special relativity, Albert Einstein said, among other things, that nothing, absolutely nothing, could travel faster than light. Many of us oftentimes take this for granted and never really stop to think about why the speed of light is the universal speed limit, or why light itself is the fastest thing that there is. Light is made up of these little tiny particles called photons. You can think of them as little tiny light balls. Now, the most important thing we need to know about these photons is that they have no mass. Why do photons have no mass? Well, for that answer, we only have to look to a little something called the Higgs field.
Fundamental particles gain their mass through interactions with the Higgs field, an energy field that exists everywhere in the universe. Pictured as follows. Imagine a group of people in beige shirts. They represent the field. And through that group of people, two initially massless particles, a fundamental particle and a photon, move to get from point A to point B. How heavy they become can be represented by their interactions with the field, which is reflected in how fast they move through it. The fundamental particle is super popular. Along the way, he is stopped by different people for a quick chat, and he ends up making his way from A to B slowly, hence gaining mass. On the other hand, the photon knows no one in that group of people. He doesn't interact with them, and hence is free to move as fast as possible from A to B. There's nothing stopping him, so he still has no mass.
Okay, so this explains why light itself is the fastest thing in the universe, but what prevents me from grabbing an object and pushing it ever increasingly harder until it reaches the speed of light? What makes it stop at around 300,000 kilometers per second?
Arguably, one of the most important equations in all physics says that mass is the property that all energy exhibits. In other words, mass and energy have a sort of equivalence. They can be thought of as the same thing. Therefore, technically, a soccer ball while in the air has more mass than that same ball at rest, because while moving, the ball has kinetic energy. And so, the faster an object moves, the more energy it has, the more massive it becomes. If I were to hit one of those pool balls you saw at the beginning of the video super hard, its mass would literally increase. It would become heavier. The important thing to note here is that to push a more massive object, more energy is required. And experimentally, it has been verified that as an object approaches the speed of light, the energy required to push it has to become infinitely hard. It is physically impossible to harness energy that can push an object to the speed of light, because the mass of that object would become infinite through the energy it acquires.
Therefore, not even Superman can manage to push that infinitely massive and energetic ball. That, in conjunction with the fact that photons have no mass, not only proves that light itself is the fastest thing in the universe, but that no particle can be accelerated to that given speed. In any way you look at it, light is, effectively, the universal speed limit.